In a similar way, Sodom and Gomorrah and the surrounding towns gave themselves up to sexual immorality and perversion. They serve as an example of those who suffer the punishment of eternal fire. Just as it was in the days of Noah, so also will it be in the days of the Son of Man. People were eating and drinking, marrying and being given in marriage up to the day Noah entered the ark. Then the flood came and destroyed them all. It was the same in the days of Lot. People were eating and drinking, buying and selling, planting and building. But the day Lot left Sodom, fire and sulfur rained down from heaven and destroyed them all. It will be just like this on the day the Son of Man is revealed. On that day, no one who is on the roof of his house with his goods inside should go down to get them. Likewise, no one in the field should go back for anything. Remember Lot's wife.
Lot's wife is turned into a pillar of salt for disobeying God. Lot and his daughters flee to the mountains, never to see Abraham again.
Then the angel took the censer, filled it with fire from the altar, and hurled it on the earth. And there came peals of thunder, rumblings, flashes of lightning, and an earthquake. Then the seven angels who had the seven trumpets prepared to sound them. The first angel sounded his trumpet, and there came hail and fire mixed with blood, and it was hurled down upon the earth. A third of the earth was burned up, a third of the trees were burned up, and all the green grass was burned up. The second angel sounded his trumpet, and something like a huge mountain all ablaze was thrown into the sea. A third of the sea turned into blood, a third of the living creatures in the sea died, and a third of the ships were destroyed. The third angel sounded his trumpet, and a great star blazing like a torch fell from the sky.
The wrath of God is coming. The wrath of God is coming on this world and on people. If you don't hear about the wrath of God, believe it, feel it, and hear it.
The day of the Lord will come like a thief. The heavens will disappear with a roar, the elements will be destroyed by fire, and the earth and everything in it will be laid bare.
Never, ever dreamed of a tsunami like the wrath of God. Infinite, omnipotent anger you don't want to tangle with on the judgment day. And God doesn't want you to tangle with it either, which is why he put forward his son at the fullness of time, born of woman, born under the law, to redeem those who were under the law, that we might be adopted, forgiven, justified, and an everlasting, joyful place with him. That's why you need to know about the wrath of God.
The end of all flesh has come before me. For the earth is filled with violence through them. Every living thing that I have made, I will blot out from the face of the ground. But I will establish my covenant with you. Make yourself an ark, and this is how you shall make it. The length of the ark shall be. To the ark, you and your whole family.
As it was in the days of Noah, so it will be at the coming of the Son of Man. For in the days before the flood, people were eating and drinking, marrying and giving in marriage, up to the day Noah entered the ark. For 40 days, the flood kept coming on the earth, and as the waters increased, they lifted the ark high above the earth. The waters rose and increased greatly on the earth, and the ark floated on the surface of the water. They rose greatly on the earth, and all the high mountains under the entire heavens were covered. The waters rose and covered the mountains to a depth of more than 20 feet. Every living thing that moved on the earth perished. Birds, livestock, wild animals, all the creatures that swarm over the earth, and all mankind. Everything on dry land that had the breath of life in its nostrils died. Every living thing on the face of the earth was wiped out. Men and animals and the creatures that move along the ground and the birds of the air were wiped from the earth. Only Noah was left, and those with him in the ark. The waters flooded the earth for 150 days.
Can God be loving and not move against wickedness? No. Can God be good and be apathetic towards evil? Absolutely not. There is the wrath of God, and it is the result of him being righteous, holy, and even loving, and good. God will judge men. He will. We must warn men. We must tell men that God, all day long, extends out his hand to a disobedient, obstinate people. But at the same time, the wrath of God comes upon the world, because God is a righteous, holy God. Have you not read the book of Revelation? This is not just Old Testament teaching. That the wrath of God will come in such a way that men will cry out, the great captains and leaders of this world will cry out that the rocks fall upon them to hide them from the wrath of the Lamb.
They did not stop worshiping demons and idols of gold, silver, bronze, stone, and wood, idols that cannot see or hear or walk. Nor did they repent of their murders, their magic arts, their sexual immorality. Revelation 16. Then I heard a loud voice from the temple saying to the seven angels, "Go, pour out the seven bowls of God's wrath on the earth." The first angel went and poured out his bowl on the land, and ugly and painful sores broke out on the people who had the mark of the beast and worshipped his image. The seventh angel poured out his bowl into the air, and out of the temple came a loud voice from the throne saying, "It is done." Then there came flashes of lightning, rumblings, peals of thunder, and a severe earthquake. No earthquake like it has ever occurred since man has been on earth. So tremendous was the quake. The great city split into three parts, and the cities of the nations collapsed. God remembered Babylon the Great and gave her the cup filled with the wine of the fury of his wrath. Every island fled away, and the mountains could not be found. From the sky, huge hailstones of about 100 pounds each fell upon men, and they cursed God on account of the plague of hail, because the plague was so terrible. The fourth angel poured out his bowl on the sun, and the sun was given power to scorch people with fire. They were seared by the intense heat, and they cursed the name of God who had control over these plagues, but they refused to repent and glorify him.
For God sent not his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. He that believeth on him is not condemned, but he that believeth not is condemned already, because he has not believed in the name of the only begotten Son of God. And this is the condemnation, that light is come into the world, and men love darkness rather than light, because their deeds were evil. For everyone that doeth evil hates the light, and neither comes to the light, lest his deeds should be reproved, or that means discovered. But he that does truth comes to the light, that his deeds may be made manifest, that they are wrought in God. There is a day coming when every person ever created in the image of God is going to be resurrected from the dead. And those who are still living will also be gathered together And there will be a judgment time. There'll be a time that you and I, every person ever born, stands before the throne of God. Don't forget this is coming. Don't forget this is a day that is still ahead of us. Every knee will bow.
The biggest question that will ever be answered is the question, which way to heaven? The most important decision that anybody will ever make is the decision that they make regarding their eternal destiny. Life here, says the Bible, is a vapor that appears for a little time and vanishes away. It is like steam off a cup of coffee, nothing more compared to eternity. Everyone will live somewhere forever without end. Where you live forever is absolutely critical. There are two options, hell and eternal punishment, or heaven and eternal joy.
Eternity! The day you stand in those granite halls before the Lord of glory and kings. The greatest men on earth are divided and split and culled. Some cast into eternal hell and some invited into eternal glory. Live for eternity.
The gospel. God sends his son into the world, the God-man. Really man, really God, really human, really divine. Lives a perfect life, fulfills the whole law, dies in the place of sinners intentionally, absorbs all the wrath of God against those who believe in him, takes away all their guilt, forgives all their sins, rises from the dead triumphant over death and hell and Satan, sins, rules with power from on high, will come again, give eternal life, raise from the dead all those who trusted in him. There is no better news.